Madam, your computer teacher of class 5. Hope you all are staying safe at your home and you have scored very good marks in PA1 examination. This time, today we will start our new chapter, chapter number 3, working with tables for the new term, summative assessment 1. So in this chapter, working with table chapter, we will discuss about the tables. How can we draw the table in MS Word? How can we format it and how can we do the calculations in a table? So first of all, we will discuss the definition of table. What is a table? Table, so I am writing here the definition of table. Table is an organized arrangement of text in the form of rows and columns. Okay, so what is the definition of a table? Table is an organized way, organized arrangement of text in the form of rows and columns. So horizontal lines are called rows and vertical lines are called columns. So table is made up of rows and columns. And the intersection of a row and column is known as cell. When we draw a row and a column, this is called cell. Okay. So we can also say that table is made up of cells. Now, why is table is useful? It is useful to present our data in a presentable way or in an effective manner. Now, there are many ways in MS Word for creating a table. So, we will see one by one each method for creating a table in computer. So, let's do the practicals. Our first method for creating a table is using table grid. So, let's see how we can create a table. First of all, we have to open our MS Word document. So for that, we will click on the All Apps. Then after, we will search for Microsoft Office. Microsoft Office has opened. Now we will search for Microsoft Word. See here, Microsoft Office Word is here. Now you will click on this and your document will be opened in front of you. Here, for creating a table, you have to go on the Insert tab. See, these all are the tabs. Okay, this is the title bar, because the title is written here. Since I have not saved this document, that's why it is named as a document 1, and Microsoft Word is an application, that's why it is written over here. These are the tabs and these are the ribbons. So we will click on the Insert tab, then after, table button will be come. You can see the grids over here. When you will move the cursor on your grid, the table will be formed. It depends on your need that how many rows and how many columns you need. I need these rows and columns, that's why I made this table. So this is the one method for creating a table. I will now tell you what is the another method for creating a table. So for that, we will delete it. First of all, we will select it from the key combination of Control and A. Now it has selected, and press the delete button. It will delete. Now the another method for creating a table is, again you will go on the Insert tab. Then after, click on the table button again. Now you don't have to move the table grid. You have to click on the Insert table. When you will click on the Insert table button, this type of dialog box has appeared. You can see over here, it has written number of columns 5, number of rows 2. It has come by default, means automatically. You can change the numbers from here. I'm writing here 8. And here I will write 4. You can change these settings also, and thereafter you have to click on the OK button. See, the table has formed in front of you. Okay. Now, the next topic has given in your book is entering data in a table. Means how can you enter data in the table? Now table has formed. Now how will you write the text inside it? See the cursor over here. The cursor is blinking over here. You can write anything here. I am writing Ram. For the next table, for the moving to the next cell, we have to click on, we have to press the tab button. Okay, you can see over here that by pressing the tab button, it has moved to the next cell. Or you can click the cursor in any cell. This is another way to moving the cursor. Now you can write the marks or anything in the form of data. I am writing 51 here. You can do the same thing whatever in your book has given in the figure number 3.3. I am doing all the practicals in front of you. If you will do also the same in your PC, you will easily learn it. Okay. So the next topic has given in your book is for selecting the cell, row, column and entire table. Means how can you select these things? So first of all, we will see how can we select the cell. For that, you can click in any cell triple times, three times. Means if you will do triple click in any cell, it will be selected like this. Okay, I am selecting this one. So for that, I have to click the mouse button three times. Now this is selected. Now the cell is selected. The next topic is row. If you want to select the row, for that you have to drag your mouse pointer to the left onwards. Now you can see the row has selected. Okay, this is the way for selecting the row. For selecting the columns, vertical lines are known as columns. So for that, we have to go on the top. If we want to select these columns, for that we have to keep our mouse pointer on the top, and then after we have to draw and drag it till the bottom or till the cell where we want to select. Now these columns have been selected. Okay, so these were the ways for selecting the cell, row and columns. The last one is for selecting the entire table. For that, if you will see on the corners, there are on the left side, you can see the table move handle over here, the four-sided head arrow. If you will click on that, the whole entire table will be selected. Okay, and if you will click anywhere else on the screen, it will be deselected. So for the selecting mouse, the entire table, what you have to do, you have to click on this table move handle. Now entire table will be selected. So these were the way for creating the table and for selecting the table.